G'day everyone, it's Clayton from Planet Canada here. Every single project we draw, private, commercial, whatever it may be, is going to be unique. Sometimes a wall is going to run out, or it's very important that our joinery works in tandem with other contractors on site, plumbing, electrical, whatever it is. Sometimes the client needs a bit of a hand reading and understanding the architectural drawings, or maybe there's just something out of the ordinary for this job that we need to communicate to everyone who picks up this job after you. This is where the 2D CAD module or feature of cabinet vision can really help you convey important design intent in your architectural and client drawings to be sure that no little miscommunications become big problems. So today, let's explore what 2D CAD features are available for us and how we can use them to our advantage. The 2D CAD menu is located here on the left-hand side. I could also click F7 on my keyboard, or even still, while I'm busy drawing my project, I can just double-click on the white space outside of the wall. Once I'm in the 2D CAD menu, you can see there are a range of tools at my disposal on top. Some of these are quite straightforward concepts, but let's highlight some of the tools you may use the most as a designer or engineer. For me, I love the dimensions tool. This gives me the ability to display a measurement of any two given points on my page. So let's say I wanted to highlight the space from the end of the wall to the end of my socket down here. I just need to click from this space to this space, and then I can place the dimension. Now that text is quite large. If I wanted to, I could use my select tool to select this CAD and then manually change the height of it, like so. I could also, if I wanted to, double click on this value, and I have the ability to manually change some of the information given. I could even turn it to text and manually put in to end of socket, text like so. Now you can provide important measurements in a matter of seconds to the center of the plumbing, to the placement of the electrical, and whatever other specific unique dimensions aren't captured by LAS schedules already. It will also be very useful for you to indicate important features of the designs, sometimes using our leaders, where I can point an arrow to a specific part of the design. So I can grab my leader tool at the top here, and if I was to point it, perhaps, to the end of my counter and out to the space, I can right click once I'm happy with the placement of the line and put in a text. And then just like that, I can convey an important information. I can also use the hatch tool to produce a shape that will fill the inside according to whatever I want. So let's say, for example, that I was wanting to display that there would be pinboard between our base cabinets and our upper cabinets. Well, I could click on my hatch tool, and then I can just draw in this space here, the measurements for where the pinboard would be placed, and then cabinet vision can fill in this space with a different hatching style. I could also, if I wanted to, click on my select tool, highlight the hatching, and then I can toggle between different hatching styles as well. I could make it a solid color. I could add in a different decorative pattern, a weave, a zigzag, and there are also wood grains available for us to use too. We have many other tools available to us. We can draw lines like so. We can add rectangles or circles. And these can be useful for highlighting very specific aspects of our design. We can also add text and text boxes. But why don't we have a look at another elevation that uses all of these features together to give us an idea of how we can elevate the information in our architectural drawings in a real world example. So I'll click return and I'll go to this second room. And now we can see an example of how we can use this CAD tool module to convey some very important information that may be necessary to those who are working on our projects in the factory, our clients, or even the installers. Using the hatching tool, I can indicate an important design feature that has to work with my joinery, even if I may not be providing this aspect of the job myself, like in the pin boards. I can use a leader and a circle to highlight a specific unique aspect of my design that may not be immediately obvious, such as the 5 mil gap from the end of my cabinet to the end of the counter. I can use the dimensions and rectangle tool to display the placement of the plumbing, or I could use the text to provide additional hardware information to clearly specify that the LED hardware received in the factory of this job needs to go here. Another key feature of the 2D CAD module is the ability to insert symbols, as well as different tables, DXF models, images, or media. If we click on the insert symbol, you'll see that there is a whole library of symbols available to us. Just for example, these can really help make our drawings clear and professional. Such as, for instance, if I wanted to add a key arrow reference marker to my work, I could find the relevant symbol, add it to my page, and just like that, I can really help elevate the quality of my work. Any of the CAD we produce on our plan or our elevation views will be available on the Drawings tab too when we create our drawing scene or center drawing. So I will do that now. So if I was to go to my Drawings tab, we'd see that on my drawing, when I bring across my scene, it includes the CAD that I've already added. I could also double click on the white space from this menu and add the CAD in myself to the drawing again. Or if I wanted to, using the insert tool from the 2D CAD menu, I could also highlight important information that I found. So I could highlight the hardware information that might help those working on these drawers on this project in the factory clearly understand some additional information, like how to construct the drawers. So that's an overview of the 2D CAD feature in Cabinet Vision. But here are just a couple more tips to help you as a designer using it more to your advantage. When I'm using my CAD, the standards I choose before I start drawing with a tool will generally become the new default for that tool. For instance, if I grab my rectangle tool and I start drawing rectangles on my page, you'll notice that the color is set to black. This means that after I have drawn my rectangles, if I wanted to change their color, I would need to click on my Select tool, click on the rectangle, and manually change each individual. Whereas if I wanted to have all of my rectangles a different color, I can click on the rectangle tool, and before I start drawing with it, change some of the information like the color, any of the line type or line width. And now, when I start drawing it, this has become the new default standard. Another way that the 2D CAD can help us is by giving us the ability to measure out like a draft. For example, using the chain tool will help me to measure out exactly where I would want to place an island bench or a reception desk on my page. So, for example, if we did that together, I can use my chained line tool. And it's still pink, fantastic. And now I know that my counter is currently 600 mil deep. So let's say I would like to have a 100 mil gap, 1100 mil gap, sorry. Length, 1100 mil gap. And you'll see that I hit tab on my keyboard and that gave me the ability to jump straight to the dimensions. And now I can filter between the different options, the different dimensions before I hit enter and finish the operation. So I've got an 1100 mil gap. And then perhaps I want another 600 mil gap for the depth of my cabinets. So I can add in that length there. And now I know where I would want to begin my peninsula wall so that I can start constructing and building my island. And just finally, we can add CAD to our plan view, our elevation view, our drawings. I could also go into my cabinet properties themselves. And I could, from the face view, double click on the white space or the CAD button and add in CAD here myself. but you'll notice it's not going to be visible from my elevation or plan view. But if I right click on this cabinet and go to its properties, I can now show plan CAD and show elevation CAD, and it will appear now from these other views. Thank you very much for listening to this video, and hopefully it has helped you get the most out of using the 2D CAD tool in Cabinet Vision. Hey, thanks so much for watching. If you'd like to see more tutorials like this one, please be sure to like and subscribe. You can also check out our other videos that will help guide you on your path to becoming a Cabinet Vision power user.